Thank you for joining me at Tantrum House Studio D. I'm Melissa Delp. Today, we're going to walk through how to play The Goonies Escape with One-Eyed Willy's Rich Stuff. The Goonies Escape with One-Eyed Willy's Rich Stuff is a cooperative mystery game for one to however many players. It's designed by Jay Cormier and Sen Fun Lim and published by The Op, who sponsored this How to Play video. This game is in the Coded Chronicles line, an at-home escape room style game where players work together to unlock clues and solve puzzles by using a unique code-revealing mechanic. In this game, you'll be playing as the Goonies and their friends, Mikey, Brand, Mouth, Data, Andy, Steph, Chunk, and Sloth. You'll experience the narrative storyline by solving puzzles during your quest to find One-Eyed Willy's rich stuff. You'll need to use the character's special skills to decode clues and reach Willy's ship, the Inferno. But be on the lookout for the Fratellis, they're never far behind. Let's dive into the adventure guide. The setup for the game is the same no matter how many players are playing. First, pass out these 6 journals to as many different players as possible. You can leave the journals for Chunk and Sloth in the box. They aren't used until Act 2. If you're playing with fewer than 6 players, or have players that don't want to or can't read, you can give more than one journal to the same player. During Act 1, Mikey's journal requires the most reading. Next, place the stack of map tiles face down. They should be in alphabetical order with letter A on the top. Do not look at the other side of the tiles. Also, place the deck of clue cards face down. Do not shuffle them or look at the front sides of the cards. They should be in numerical order with 1 on top. Place the treasure map and doubloon on the table, along with the secret envelopes. You can look at the outside of the envelopes, but don't open them until you're instructed to. You'll want to leave space in the middle of the table for the map tiles. Throughout the game, you'll be instructed to add map pieces in specific places. Here's a little warning though, by the end of the game, it is pretty big, so you'll want to play on a large surface. So now let's talk about how the game plays. I'm going to have to show some of the components to explain the rules, but I'll try to keep from spoiling anything. Throughout the game, you'll be told to place map sections face up on the table. Each tile has a specific place in the caves, and the instructions will tell you where to place them in relation to the other tiles. At different points in the game, you'll have access to different characters. Each character has a special ability and booklet. The characters on a tile can interact with objects using their special ability. Mikey can explore. To explore the pipes, place Mikey's character in front of the 3-digit number. Now you have a 4-digit number you can look up in his journal. You should see the name of the tile he's on. If not, double-check the number. Some characters, like Andy, have the use ability. You need to combine 2 items. First, an item with a single-digit number, like the wrench, and then an item with a double-digit number, like the lantern. That will give you 3 digits. When you place Andy's number in front, you get a 4-digit number you can look up in her journal. So the entries in each book are unique because the characters have different abilities and interact in different ways. An entry might give you clues to solve a puzzle, or tell you to reveal a card. Place a new map section, open a secret envelope, or place certain characters in a room, or it might not help you at all. Unlike many other games, in this one, players are not controlling specific characters. As a group, you should discuss which characters should interact with which objects. Brand can pick up things. Steph explains things in a clearer way. Mouth can decipher certain symbols in writing. And Data, well, he has gadgets. Instead of interacting with numbers on the map tiles, Data can solve mini puzzles to activate his gadgets. Solving the puzzle gives you a 4-digit number that you look up in Data's journal. You have to combine it, though, with the letter of the map tile he's on. not every gadget is useful in every situation. Some combinations could even result in a penalty, like moving the Fratellis forward. If you're familiar with the movie, you know that the crime family, the Fratellis, are chasing after the kids. In this game, you're trying to stay ahead of them. Incorrectly solving a puzzle will sometimes penalize you by moving them forward. You also have to move them if the code you look up isn't in a journal. But there are also regular actions that cause them to move. It's not always because you've done something wrong. If the Fratellis move onto a tile with one or more of your characters and you can't continue forward, you've been caught. Mark a space on the Caught by the Fratellis tracker on the back of the rulebook, and then place the Fratellis on the first space in the previous room. In this example, it would be space number one. Getting caught by the Fratellis isn't great, but it doesn't end your game. It just affects your score. Once you finish the game, you'll compare the number of times you were caught with this scoring chart to determine your achievement level. If you're having trouble with a puzzle, you can get a hint on page 7 of the adventure guide. Look for the room you're in and the entry number for the first hint. Hint 1 is free. If you look at hint 2 or the solution for a puzzle, you'll have to move the Fratellis forward. As a reminder, these hints are highlighted in yellow. The puzzles will use clues, cards, and components you find during the game. You won't need any outside, specialized knowledge to solve them, but you will need to use some observation skills and logical thinking. Steph's ability Explain can also be useful. Familiarity with the movie will make some of the decisions and puzzles easier, but it's not necessary. When you solve a puzzle, you might be instructed to reveal cards or open envelopes. You might also be told to remove some cards or components from the game. If you're told to remove something that you've never even revealed, that's okay. You might have just solved the puzzle quickly without all the clues. The game has 3 acts that take about an hour each. You can stop after an act and save your progress in this intermission envelope, or you can keep playing and finish in one sitting. So that's everything you need to know to play The Goonies Escape with One-Eyed Willy's Rich Stuff. To get started, turn to entry 1000 in Mikey's journal. It's up to you to save the Goondocks. So that's everything you need to know about how to play The Goonies. The Goonies.